Daniel was a nervous boy. He was scared of problematic situations. However, life is full of them. Whenever a problem arose in Daniel's life, he would simply start crying. Seeing him in tears, his mother would help him out. However, this made him more dependent and less courageous. His father didn't like this at all. But there was hardly anything he could do. One day, he saw Daniel crying. He went to him and asked the matter. Daniel told him that he had borrowed his friend James' bicycle, but someone stole it while he was in the park.
"Only Mom can help me out of this," said Daniel with tears in his eyes.
"I'm sure she can," comforted his father. "But you can also solve the problem on your own."
"How?" asked Daniel.
"Okay," said father. "Now stop crying and listen to me carefully. To solve any problem, first identify it and list the options for fixing it. You lost your friend's bike. What do you think you can do to fix it?"
Daniel thought for a while and then laid down his options.
"I can stay away from my friend, or I can lie to him that one of my friends lost it, or I can give him my remote controlled plane. He really likes it."
"Okay," said father. "It is good you have some options to fix the problem. Now you need to rate the options. Write all your options on paper and rate them according to their being ethical, rightful, and honest." Daniel did as his father told him. He rated the three options he had and was left with just the last option. Avoiding his friend or lying to him would be disastrous and would hurt his feelings a lot. So, the only option that was left with him was to offer his friend the remote-controlled plane that he liked a lot. Daniel told the option he picked to his father. It was the hardest one, but was the only suitable option that seemed fit. Seeing this, father comforted him. "Son, it is always hard to do the right thing, but in the end, it pays." The next day, Daniel went to his friend and told him all about the bike. He apologized to him and offered him his remote control plane instead of the bike. However, his friend was stubborn. He wanted his bike back, no matter what. This meant there was a bigger problem for Daniel. He went to his father and the two started thinking again. This time, Daniel came up with a unique solution. He offered to buy his friend the same kind of bike. The only thing he asked from him for was time. He promised to buy him the bike after saving his pocket money. His friend agreed to the solution. Encouraged by this,
Daniel started saving money. He even did small jobs for his neighbors, like walking the dog every morning, fetching milk from the market daily, etc., to earn money in a short period of time. Soon, he had enough money. Daniel bought the bike and thanked his father for helping him solve the problem on his own. His father smiled and said,
"The lesson is not over, son. After fixing the problem, you need to analyze what led to the problem in the first place."
"My forgetfulness," replied Daniel shyly.
"It's good that you know it. So, from now on, I am sure you will take corrective steps to ensure that you won't repeat the mistake again."
"Sure, Dad," said Daniel. "You have taught me the lesson of a lifetime."
From then on, whenever Daniel faced any problem, he followed the I or Pi rule. First, he identified the problem. Next, he listed the options to fix it. Then, he rated the options. Next, he picked the most suitable option. Then, he implemented the solution. And finally, he evaluated the whole situation to avoid the problem from cropping again. Lila and Anna were cousins. They lived in the same house and went to the same school. Lila was a very popular girl. She was beautiful, chirpy, and fun to be around. On the other hand, Anna was a quiet fellow. She was always conscious about how other girls and boys saw her. She disliked the fact that her skin wasn't very healthy and she had zits all over her face. As time passed by, Anna started developing low self-esteem. Every time there was a get-together at her place, everyone would praise Lila for her beautiful skin, while Anna was looked upon as an ugly duckling. As time passed by, Anna started getting depressed and frustrated. She was being constantly compared with her cousin. She often wondered what was Lila's secret that made her skin look so beautiful. One day, she saw Lila buy a skin cream from the chemist. Immediately after she left, she went to the chemist and bought the same cream. Happy to find Lila's secret, she went home and rubbed the cream on her face several times. With a thick, greasy layer of the cream on her face, she went to bed. That night, she dreamt of waking up with flawless skin that would attract everyone's attention. Next morning, when she woke up, she went straight to her mom.
"What happened to your face?"
yelled Mom.
"Isn't it beautiful now?"
giggled Anna.
"Oh God!"
cried Mom.
"Go wash your face now. And don't worry, it will go away."
Anna couldn't understand why Mom asked her to wash her face. She didn't want the charm the cream had left on face to vanish anyway. Nonetheless, she went to the bathroom to wash her face.
Oh my God! What have I done?
She cried the moment she saw the mirror. Her face was all red and full of ugly zits due to the cream. Seeing her face, she sat on the bathroom floor and started crying.
What happened?
Asked Lila when she entered the bathroom. Why are you crying? Anna told her that she used the same cream that Lila bought from the chemist, but it spoiled her face.
You did that to me on purpose, I know.
Anna blamed Lila.
You don't want me to look beautiful. That is why you misled me into buying that cream.
Relax, said Lila patiently. It is nothing like the way you think. All you need to do is take care of your skin. If you wanted flawless skin, you should have talked with me or your mom. Following others blindly doesn't help.
But what should I do now?
Asked Anna. Don't worry, comforted Lila. It will go away. You just have to follow few things. Look, skin is the most important and sensitive part of our body. It becomes ugly when we don't take proper care of it. Always remember to wash your face at least thrice daily, in the morning, after you wake up, after coming back from school, and before you go to bed at night. Consult a doctor or a professional and use the right cleanser for your skin type. Girls at our age don't do makeup. But still, if you wore a little makeup, make sure that you remove it before going to bed.
And what about the creams they advertise on the television?
Asked Anna. Are those? Remarked Lila. You should moisturize your skin, but don't overdo it. Again, choose a moisturizer according to your skin type. I have dry skin, while you have oily. The moisturizers we use will be obviously different. Remember, when you go out in the sun, apply sunscreen all over your body. Also, take care of your diet. It is very important. Drink lots of water and eat fresh fruits and vegetables. They are very good for the skin. And for these zits, don't pick them or else they will leave scars.
It seems like taking care of skin is a big task,
remarked Anna. It is, said Lila. But once you develop a routine, it becomes easy. And it is also worth the effort. Anna followed Lila's instructions. Within a fortnight, she started seeing her skin improving. She realized that all this while it was in her hands to make her skin look good. Nonetheless, it didn't take long for that ugly duckling to change into a beautiful swan.
Let's all go for a walk. We can talk about so many things as we walk. Left, right, left. Left, right, left. Let's go for a walk. Let's go for a walk. On the way we'll talk. On the way we'll talk. Of this and that. Of this and that. You can ask the questions and I will answer why. You can ask the questions and I will answer why. When we reach your house, we'll wave goodbye. When we reach your house, we'll wave goodbye. See you, dear friend. See you tomorrow. We can go for a walk again tomorrow. Bye.
Harry was an angry little fellow. He was often rude with people around him. Harry didn't like being polite with people. His parents and teachers often lectured him about using words like thank you, sorry, please, etc. However, nothing they said or did affected him. Whenever he wanted something, he would simply snatch it or throw a fit to get what he wanted. If anyone asked him something, he would simply make fun of the other people and walk away. One day, Harry was playing in his outhouse with his cat. An old woman was passing by his house. She requested Harry to give her directions about a particular house.
Can't you see, old woman?
Scorned Harry.
I am playing here. Go get the bell and Mom will tell you.
Hearing this, the old woman turned red with rage. She cursed Harry.
From now on, whatever rude word you utter would leave an ugly scar on your face. Go away!
Shouted Harry and continued playing with his cat. Suddenly, the cat flung its paw and scratched his forehead, giving him his first scar. Now, it so happened that couple of boys were playing outside. Their ball fell in Harry's outhouse and they came to get it.
Look, here comes the blind squad,
laughed Harry.
If you boys can't keep your ball in control, why play?
Hearing this, two of the boys climbed the outhouse. They punched Harry in the face and left with their ball. Harry had another scar on his face. Unable to take it, Harry went inside. When his mom saw him, she asked what had happened. Harry retorted,
"What do you care? Go do your kitchen work."
Saying this, Harry rushed towards the bathroom to wash his face and this time hit his nose. At night, while the entire family was having dinner, Harry asked his little brother,
"Hey, retarded, give me that fork."
Little Tom placed the fork near Harry's hand. But the moment Harry ate with it, he cut his lips.
"Look what I've done, idiot!"
said Harry angrily and rushed towards his room. As he was in a hurry, he slipped from the stairs and hurt his eye. Mom and Dad became worried what had happened to Harry. But none of them had the courage to talk with him. Harry was both angry and in pain. He didn't like himself when he saw his face in the mirror. Harry started thinking about the whole thing. He was angry that every time he said something rude, it hurt him. Suddenly, he heard a knock at the door. It was Father. With tears in his eyes, Harry said,
"Please, Dad, leave me alone."
It seemed Harry had grown tired of being rude and getting punished for it every time. Surprisingly, the moment he uttered the word "please," the scar on his forehead disappeared. Harry realized what was to be done next. The next morning was the beginning of a new life for Harry. He talked politely with everyone, and with each polite word, his scars disappeared. That evening, while Harry was in the outhouse, he saw the same old woman. He rushed to and said,
"Thank you, madam."
The old lady smiled and said,
"I hope you won't forget this lesson ever."
Children, don't hurt animals. They too feel pain and cry, just like you and me.
I had a little pony, his name was Dapple Grey. I lent him to a lady to ride a mile away. She whipped him, she slashed him, she rode him through the mire. I would not lend my pony now for all the lady's hire. I had a little pony, his name was Dapple Grey. I lent him to a lady to ride a mile away. She whipped him, she slashed him,